accurate sensors technologies.
Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the true color infrared pyrometer or ratio pyrometer. So what is true color or ratio pyrometer? In true color pyrometer, there are two separate shortest wavelength detectors placed one after the other like a sandwich in the instrument. That's why it's also known as the sandwich detector. Both detectors measures the same hot object temperature. It is also known as the ratio pyrometer because it determines the temperature by forming the radiation ratio. What is the measuring principle? A true color pyrometer determines the temperature at two separate wavelengths by calculating its ratio. The ratio of these two radiates is proportional to the temperature of the object. That's why we choose the detector with the shortest wavelength ranging from 0.7 micron to 1.15 micron. So, how true color pyrometer temperature measure? In this picture, we have considered true color pyrometer measuring a hot object temperature to atmospheric condition. Now consider a case when there is no atmospheric condition is present. Then pyrometer can see a clear view of the hot object and determines the 100% signal by the detectors. Say suppose detector 1 determines the 500 unit and detector 2 will determine the 1000 unit. Now consider a case where the atmospheric condition is present. Then pyrometer cannot able to see a clear view of the object and then there will be a loss of in the signal. And say suppose there is a 50% loss in the signal, then the detector will determine the 250 units and detector 2 will determine the 500 units. In this graph, the actual temperature of the object is 1500 degree and the emissivity is 1. This is for the clear view object. Detector 1 determines the 500 units and detector 2 determines the 1000 units. And since this is the ratio pyrometer, we divide the detector 1 by detector 2. So we divide the 500 unit by 1000 unit and the ratio we get is 0.5. The pyrometer we calibrated in such a way that when it sees the 0.5 ratio, it reads 1500 degrees Celsius. Now consider the obstruct view object. The yellow graph is shown for the obstruct view and this is due to the loss of the 50% signal due to the atmospheric condition. So detector 1 determines 250 degrees Celsius and units and detector 2 determines the 500 units. So we took the ratio of 250 divided by 500, it also comes to 0.5. And we already calibrated the instrument for 0.5, so it shows the temperature, it reads temperature 1500 degrees Celsius, even though there is a loss in the signal. So what is construction of the true color pyrometer? So true color pyrometer consists of the lens, the aperture, and then there will be a signal condition. So the source will emit the energy through the atmospheric condition. Lens will gather this energy and send it to aperture. Aperture will send it to the filter and filter will give it to the sandwich detector. And there the two detectors are already there. So this will select the two signals to the signal condition processing. Why true color pyrometer is a true color pyrometer is can measure the temperature of the small object. It also can measure the temperature even pyrometer is not completely by the target object. It can measure through the dust, smoke, steam or dirty windows. A true color pyrometer can also measure for the unknown emissivity or where the emissivity is changing continuously with respect to the process. Example is a molten metal. True color pyrometer is having E-slope adjustment to read the temperature correctly. So what is the difference between the true color pyrometer and the wavelength? True color pyrometer is having shortest wavelength, general wavelength. It is so sensitive to the temperature measurement and calculate the average temperature. And it is not applicable for the low temperature applications. It measures temperature above 600. And in dual wavelength, they require a specific wavelength for specific applications. This is 20 times less sensitive to the temperature change. And it can measure for the lower temperature application. Example is like in petrochemicals, there is a sulfur recovery unit applications where it requires to measure the temperature of the gas as well as the measure the temperature of the refractory. So both this application requires this separate wavelength. So the which is away from each other and this can be used for the dual wavelength. So what are the advantages and limitations of the true color pyrometer? The advantage is that highly accurate and sensitive to the temperature measurement. It measures the correct temperature if the signal is and even if the even the emissivity varies. Limitation is it costlier solution as compared to the single color pyrometer, and it's not suitable for the lower temperature range applications. So ASC has below two color pyrometer series. One is the non-focusable series, in which A to C are focus level based on the temperature and range it is divided. Then there is a focusable series, which is A450C plus, which is having inbuilt display and parametrizing. Then there are fiber optic solutions. First is fiber optic solution by A450C and A450C FOPL. And then there is a portable solution available with the solution. And these are the applications where we can use the two color pyrometer. We can use in steel industries for blast furnace or hot stone on. For cement industries, for kiln boring applications, and then glass for the temperature measurement of the glass core, molten metal. For forging industry, induction heating, we can for petrochemicals like this SRU, for these pyrometers. So thank you. If you have any queries, please write us on the below email ID, sales@accurate.com.